Hello YouTube, this is Bowtied Media. Today I have a review of Slippy's Everything and Nothing at All EP. Slippy has been a fairly staple producer for the Monster Cat label for quite some time now. He primarily produces some trap or hybrid trap and dabbles a little bit in the heavier side of the future-based genre. His style of hybrid trap relies a lot on a melodic hook to make his songs more unique than other trap tracks. Each of the 6 songs on this EP follow a fairly similar flow and structure, but Slippy manages to keep each of them feeling unique and interesting. It's definitely not the newest and freshest trap out in the music industry right now, but I am a fan of this stuff. You just don't need to reinvent the wheel every single time a new project comes out. But one thing I do love about Slippy is his use of vocalists quite often. He's got 5 vocalists actually on this EP. 2 of them go uncredited, but then he's got Fiora on Zenith, he's got Danika Nadeau on Resonate, and finally London Thor on Dawn. When Slippy goes hard on these tracks, which he does almost every single time, I think the female vocalists really add a nice flavor to the tracklist. But you know, the one song where he doesn't actually have any real vocals, I almost enjoyed the most. That song being The Valley. While it doesn't have any vocals here, and I praise him for using vocals on his tracks, I really enjoy this track. We don't often see Slippy bring out a crashing bass line like you see on this track, The Valley, and honestly, after hearing it, I just want some more of it. When those bass hits are paired with that melodic high pass on the main line, it kind of forms a split second of melodic bliss. He also played around with that idea or motif a lot more on the second drop with the bass and melodic sections, and I actually liked it a lot more than the first. And while the song felt short-lived, it left me wanting more, which is not a bad thing. Another thing I need to praise Slippy for is his atmosphere across this entire EP. I find a lot of artists, especially trap artists, like to just hone in on the beats and the fattiness of the track without so much of actually creating some atmosphere. But that's where I think Slippy really shines, as he kind of first and foremost puts out that atmosphere and creates a first 30 seconds of most of these tracks to establish what he's trying to convey. Only then, after he's established that, does he come in with those heavy hitting drops. Stand Still is a track that I think best represents this idea that I'm talking about. To me, this track should have been the outro instead of Zenith. It just has a much stronger build, drop, and eventually just a slow fade out. Speaking of Zenith, I feel like Zenith and Resonate with Danika Nadeau. Speaking of Zenith, that track and Resonate, I think, are like your classic, almost clear-cut Slippy tracks. Good vocal performances, a greater emphasis on that high melody line, and right before the drop, the usage of that high pass filter. Resonate is my personal favorite from this 6-song EP, as I think I can just enjoy it more. I find myself just listening to it and putting a smile on my face more so than any other track here. Danika Nadeau is always a pleasure to have on a track, and again, just emphasizing that high pass filter that he loves to play around with, it just works so well, and sometimes it doesn't, but in this track and for most of this EP, he executes it pretty marvelously. So in the end, while Slippy's production style doesn't really vary from project to project, a lot of it sounds pretty similar and could be grouped, yeah, in a similar vein, it is a unique take on trap that I don't see a ton of other artists doing all that often, especially creating that atmosphere that Slippy tends to do over and over again. So while trap may feel like it's just everywhere right now and it's so overused, Slippy finds a way to make it unique. Slippy's melding of melodic switching highs and powerful rumble lows just works so well together, especially when layered on top of a trap beat. This EP isn't anything brand new, creative, or innovative, but it is a refining of his own niche. And for that, Slippy's Everything and Nothing at All EP is going to score a 7. But thank you guys so much for watching. I have been Bowtied Media. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. This is day 1 of review month, where all of May I'm going to be reviewing a brand new project, EPs, mixtapes, LPs. If you want to see the whole list of my plan for the month so far, you can go check out my Twitter at Bowtied Media to see what it's all going to be. But I've been Bowtied Media again, and I will see you guys in another video.